The meeting, dubbed Working as a Team to Boost Businesses and Revenue Collection, was organized by the Tax Board Uganda Revenue Authority in conjunction with the Kampala City Traders Association. The traders say the multiple taxes have forced them into abandoning several investments so as to stay afloat.
As CASITA, we have been having several meetings with sectoral heads to make sure that we clearly identify the problems affecting the business community. So we are having a special paper we are going to present to the Commissioner General, and which we shall have continuous meetings to make sure that the trader is effectively represented, and then possible solutions, which even at times can be handled with the policy level at the Ministry of Finance.
Gives an opportunity for every citizen, every person living in this country who is a consumer, to pay a fair share of the tax. Now the challenge has been the businesses which are supposed to work as tax collecting agents on behalf of government have not been doing this. And IFRIS, which you heard us talk about extensively, is the technology that we've put in place to enable us collect, assess and collect VAT accurately. But IFRIS has another advantage besides just collecting tax. It will help the businesses manage their records very efficiently, because if you have the IFRIS software deployed in your business, it is another way of managing your stock.
They also want more awareness campaigns about the taxation policies so as not to be caught on the wrong side of the law. According to URA Commissioner General John Musinguzi, the electronic fiscal receipting and invoicing system has boosted compliance in tax collections.
If you're importing anything that is below $500, it's really free of tax. You are returning and you have bought your pieces of clothes and so on, and they are less than 500. Really, you will not be asked to pay tax. And if anyone asks you to pay tax, you say no. I know the law and this is what it says. So it is as simple as that. But if it is more, then you have an obligation to declare. If you have bought goods worth 10,000, even if you are returning from a trip abroad, you have an obligation to declare the value that you have imported and pay the right tax.
He further stated that as a way of stimulating production and widening the tax base, they reckon introducing a modernized technology to bridge the gaps within the system. Story by Josephine Lunkuse for the news.